organization branding and culture, these are very two important elements. And I strongly believe branding is both ways, internal as well as external. Now, when we hire, the starting point, touch point for a candidate is the recruitment process. What kind of an impression we leave on those prospective candidates? How was their experience with our overall recruitment or hiring processes? Did they get excited while, you know, interviewing? Did they feel that, you know, somebody was there who took care of them and who explained them what is the expectation out of this incumbent? All this minute stuff also has got a lot of significance when it comes to employer branding. Then, of course, you know, the onboarding or induction experience, then the entire whole gamut of employee life cycle till the time exit. Now, we tend to forget the starting point, which is the hiring or induction and exit experience also. Employee's life cycle could be fantastic, but my exit experience is not great. And then that doesn't leave a very good taste in those exiting employees. So exiting employees also are very, very important part of the entire branding exercise. Otherwise, these days, everybody is socially well connected. And, you know, if I did not had a very good experience, you know, I would go to external social networking sites and I might post that. So all your effort throughout is immaterial in that context. And hence, this is very important when you come to, when it comes to internal branding. External branding would be, of course, these days organizations have got a mandate to drive CSR related stuff. And then what kind of a employer you are, how well you are regarded in the market. And then, you know, that's why people normally, you know, in their advertisement say we are equal opportunity company, and everybody is trying in their own unique way to kind of attract the best talent and strengthen their employer branding. So these are just a few of the examples.